प्रांजल। Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the most awaited ICAI Award Ceremony 2021. The felicitation of Oman's commerce toppers and successful chartered accountants passed out from the Indian schools in Oman. Organized under the aegis of the Board of Directors, Indian Schools in Oman, powered by the Muscat chapter of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. It is a proud privilege of Indian Schools Ahar to host this event, an event which also seeks to draw the curtain of mystery that conceals the veritable plethora of opportunities that awaits every single student who pursues the path of chartered accountancy with zeal and zest. Because let me tell you, CA somehow is simultaneously the most feared and the most coveted career path for commerce students even now. Its prestige as alluring as ever. To assuage those very fears, we have a Q&A session. Your queries will be answered by our eminent resource persons. Parents and students can send their questions in the chat box, which will be taken up later by the professionals present here with us today. Now, as a commerce student, this event is nothing if not cathartic. After all the jokes about unbalanced balance sheets and free marks, there awaits the apex body of accountants, the ICAI, with its lakhs of members and unlimited opportunities, certificates, mementos, and cash prizes in tow. This event would not have been possible without the glorious patronage of His Majesty Sultan Haitham bin Tariq, to whom we are immensely grateful on behalf of the entire Indian diaspora in Oman, which continues to flourish under His Majesty's gracious support. We are indebted to His Majesty for providing everything needed to preserve the safety of citizens and residents during the Sultanate's exposure to the effects of the tropical storm Shaheen. We extend our hearty thanks to the Ministry of Education, which guides and supports the Board of Directors' mission of providing the best possible education and opportunities to the Indian students in Oman.
The National Anthem represents the national identity, unity, and culture of a country. It is one among the most potent factors that contribute to developing and enriching our patriotism. Let us begin this program with the Royal Anthem of Oman and the National Anthem of India. I request all of you to kindly stand for the national anthems.
You may all take your seats. An impactful leader and an inspiration to all. Words cannot describe her vision, wisdom, and passion for best education and best school. She is an amazing leader who has shaped countless lives. Yes, it's none other than our beloved principal, Ms. Sanchita Verma. Ma'am, to welcome the gathering.
Good evening, namaskar, and salam alaikum. Honorable chief guest of the evening, Dr. Nasir bin Salim bin Nasir Al Ghanbusi, Director General, Batina, South Governorate, Ministry of Education. Respected Chairman, Board of Directors, Dr. Sivakumar Manikam, distinguished guests of honor, CA Ravi Deoda, Chairman of the ICI Muscat Chapter, and CA Jay Chera, Chairman, Board of Studies, ICAI. Esteemed resource persons for the evening, CA Vandana D. Nagpal, Director, Board of Studies, ICAI, and ex-IAF Air Commodore, Dr. Ashminder Singh Behel, Consultant Dean, Center of Excellence at ICAI. Respected members on the Board of Indian Schools in Oman, Senior Principal and Education Advisor, Sri MP Vinoba Ji, SMC Presidents and members of the SMCs, all executive members of the ICAI fraternity in Oman, principals of all Indian schools in Oman, staff, parents, and dear students, a very warm welcome to this eminent award ceremony. At the very outset, we would like to extend our sincere respect and heartfelt gratitude to His Majesty Sultan Haitham bin Tariq for his generosity towards the Indian community in the Sultanate. We thank him for his unsparing support to the educational needs of the children of Indian diaspora in the Sultanate. May the Almighty grant long life to His Majesty and peace, happiness, and prosperity to the people of Oman. The Association of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, Muscat Chapter, with Indian schools has been steadfast and unwavering. ICAI truly believes in encouraging these students, for it deems that when they are motivated, they tend to work harder in future, and certainly their performances get better. This is why this event aims to acknowledge and appreciate both the present and past out students of the commerce stream every year for their remarkable accomplishments in the field of commerce. Toppers never say that they are toppers, rather they prove they are. Commerce toppers are felicitated for their dedication and commitment, thus making their schools proud with their outstanding academic performance. We are here to also appreciate the successful CA candidates, and we are also here to give credit to the winners of the ICAI Commerce Quiz, who have not only made the school, but also the country proud by their outstanding achievement. My hearty congratulations to all of them. This event truly showcases the commitment and dedication of these students. As we have virtually gathered here today to honor the success of our marvelous students, I am glad to respectfully and cordially welcome you all and sincerely thank ICAI Muscat Chapter. Succeeding in life is as simple as being a good student. All you have to do is pay attention, work hard, and give it your best shot. Have a great evening. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for the warm welcome. Now, I would like to request our Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Nasir bin Salim bin Nasir Al Ghanbusi, Director General, Batina South Governorate, Ministry of Education, to deliver the inaugural address.
Dr. Nasir, you are on mute. Yes.
Now, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dr. Sivakumar Manikam, Chairman, Board of Directors, Indian Schools. Mr. J. Chera, Chairman, Board of Studies. Mr. Ravi Deora, Chairman, ICAI Muscat Chapter, members of the Indian School Board and Institute of Chartered Accountants, India, principals, teachers, and their students. Good evening to all of you. First of all, thank you for inviting me for this important function where students are felicitated for their academic excellence. It is really a reward for their hard work, and at the same time, it is a great motivation for other students as well. I thank the Indian schools and ICAI Muscat chapter for the kind invitation they have extended to me. I have great admiration for the Indian schools, the quality of education they give to the students, and the result they produce, both in scholastic and co-scholastic domains. I also understand that Indian schools give admission to the students of other nationalities, and I am happy to know that children of different nationalities, cultures, languages, and traditions study together, grow up together in a very healthy and peaceful environment. I appreciate the great work done by ICAI Muscat chapter for the development of accounting profession in Oman by sharing their knowledge and skills. The award for students who have excelled in commerce stream, which they have instituted, and the motivational talks they give to the students to pursue chartered accountancy as a career are very encouraging and praiseworthy. Thank you once again for encouraging students to excel in life, and I wish all the best for Indian schools and the members of the ICAI Muscat chapter. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Indeed, a great commencement for a great event. Next, we have the presidential address from the backbone of the entire Indian education network in Oman. That's right, Dr. Shiv Kumar Manikam, Chairman, Board of Directors, Indian Schools in Oman, whose achievements are so numerous that it takes hours just to account for them all. He is a published researcher and writer renowned for his gripping articles on science and technology. He's an academician par excellence who currently leads the e-learning department at the Oman Technical College and the ex-academic chair in the school managing committee of Indian School Muscat. May I invite the chairman, board of directors, Dr. Shiv Kumar Manikam, for the presidential address.
Thank you. Dr. Nasir bin Salim bin Nasir Al Ghanbousi, Director General, Batina South Governorate, Ministry of Education. C.A. J. Chayara, Chairman, Board of Studies, ICAI. C.A. Ravi Diora, Chairman, ICAI Muscat Chapter. Members on the Board of Indian Schools in Oman, distinguished speakers and resource persons for this evening, proud awardees, principals, teachers, students, and dear parents. Good evening. We are gathered here to celebrate the achievement of students who, through their persevering effort, have earned personal distinction as well as accolades for alma mater and their parents. The students include the toppers in the commerce stream from among all Indian schools in Oman and the Indian schools alumni who passed CA final examinations in the recent past. Congratulations to you on your remarkable achievements. Your achievement shows all the others, especially the students who will be appearing for their final examinations this year, that beginning well is good and important, but greater still is the art of finishing well. It is very important to have the determination to finish well and finish strong in life. It is this burning desire that will bring you success in the end, as has been shown by these brilliant students who are being felicitated this evening. The hard work and dedication of students towards their studies have brought them here to get felicitated. It is an honor for them as well as their parents. On behalf of the Board of Directors, Indian Schools in Oman, I would like to congratulate you on your grit and determination that brought you success. The role played by ICAI Muscat Chapter in propagating and promoting chartered accountancy as a career is praiseworthy. The talks given as part of this program by experienced and competent CA professionals are very informative, and they throw light on the general guidelines that all CA aspirants should know. On behalf of the Board of Directors, Indian Schools in Oman, I thank the officials of ICAI Muscat Chapter for patronizing this event and motivating our students to excel in their life. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words. Now, we have before us a charismatic personality who possesses immense knowledge in his several fields of expertise. Yes, it's none other than our guest of honor, C.A. Jay Chaira, a renowned member of the ICAI with innumerable credentials under his belt. He has been associated with ICAI activities since 1995. He has held many committees as the chairman, such as the Professional Development Committee, Student Skill Enrichment, Committee for Financial Markets and Investors Protection. Owing to his exceptional contributions, he has received several prestigious awards. Sir, you are an inspiration to many. I request you, sir, to address and enlighten the gathering.
Thank you very much, Meghna. A very good evening to all of you. Dr. Nasir, Director General, Batna South Governorate, Ministry of Education, Mrs. Sanchita Verma, Principal Indian School, Sohar, Dr. Sivakumar Manikan, Chairman, Board of Studies, Indian Schools, Oman, C.A. Ravi Devra, Chairman, ICAI Muscat Chapter, C.A. Vanna Nagpal, Director, Board of Studies, C.A. Gaurav Kapoor, Chairperson, Students Affairs and Professional Development, ICAI Muscat, C.A. Ashminder Bahel, Dean, Center of Excellence, ICAI, all my chartered accountant friends and student friends, once again, a very good evening to all of you. Let me first compliment Pranjal and Meghna for doing this MOC wonderfully well, wonderfully well. I can say even better than professionals. And compliments to the Muscat Chapter for selecting them. The way the program is happening, I think it's so professional. They are handling it so beautifully. That is really great. Well, friends, I'm really very delighted to be a part of this particular program. Because of COVID, we have embraced technology, and because of that, last year, I got an opportunity to interact with many chapters of ICAI. And Muscat Chapter is also one of them. I hope so that in the coming years, we get an opportunities to have some physical meetings and have some wonderful programs together. Well, I'm really very happy to see to it that today we are going to felicitate the students who have performed very well in their academics, in their school, as well as chartered accountancy. Well, I can surely say that if you're a student of commerce, then Institute of Chartered Accountants of India offers you one of the best programs, which is global in nature. Today, we have MOUs and MRAs across the globe with all the major countries. So a student who is pursuing chartered accountancy, he has a global passport. That I can surely say. And can you imagine? Of course, the CA course of India is comparatively a little tougher, while some other institutes might be having 12 papers or maybe 8 papers or something like that, you have 20 papers. And each and every paper is quite comprehensive. So that would mean if somebody invests his 3 to 4 years in the learnings of ICAI, I'm sure about it, the knowledge that he acquires, whether he'll be the best across the world, whether it is auditing or finance I am sure about taxation, because Indian tax law, if somebody can go through that, then I think other tax laws across the globe would be a cakewalk for him. So much of complications here that once he goes through it, he can, you know, very easily accept that tax laws across the globe. So one interesting thing is that because of these MOUs, MRAs, today if you are pursuing chartered accountancy from India, yes, you are a global professional. We have information technology inbuilt. We are even now discussing with our students data analytics and artificial intelligence. We do understand that technology is the need of the hour. We had a number of programs on the technology aspect. We have practical training, which is the base of CA profession, right? 3 years of articleship. And interestingly, in the recent year, we have allowed the students even to go for 18 months industrial training. So it can be a wonderful combination of articleship as well as industrial training, which can give them a 360 degree view of the profession. At the same time, we have management and communication skills program. I am sure people sitting here, Raviji and Gauravji and all, will agree that communication skills, management skills are utmost essential. Utmost essential. There are two important things in life: doing work, and second, how to get the work. Right? Getting the work is only possible if you are wonderful in management, if you have people skill, if you have persuasive communication, and then comes doing the work, that is the technical skills. So we are going hand in hand with that. Board of Studies is split into two parts: Board of Studies Operations, Board of Studies Academics. And friends, Board of Studies is putting in too much of efforts to improve upon the study material, making them more crisp, making them more meaningful. We have started with the PDF file. Any part of the world, you can download the study material of ICI immediately. That is 24/7 available. Not only that, now we are putting up in the audio format also, so that the entire curriculum of CA will be available sooner in the audio format. Student can listen to it. Not only that, in the days to come, maybe over a period of 2 to 3 years, there'll be embedded videos. So if you are going through some topics, say derivatives or consolidation, you find it a little complicated, just click it and some expert will be there to explain you this concept. So this is where ICI is moving, and there are so many other initiatives, but today we are here to encourage our young brains. So I would not get into the details of that. My compliments to the chapter for having wonderful events. I have seen the events of Muscat chapter, and I can say that they are wonderful, excellent events. Compliments to Raviji, Gauravji, and the entire team. And I'm sure in some other program, we can have some more interactions on this. Today, it is a time to encourage our youngsters. Thanks a lot for the opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Your speech was icing to the cake of your achievements. And thank you for your kind words of appreciation. Next, we have the chairman of the ICAI Muscat chapter, C. Ravi Deora, a qualified chartered accountant with over 20 years of experience in finance, taxation, and internal audit. He has served the chapter in various positions over the last 7 years. He is currently working with the Oman Cement Company, SAOG, as the head of internal audit. He is a strategic advisor and has exceptional leadership qualities. May I request our guest of honor, C. Ravi Deora, to address the gathering.
Thank you, Ian. And actually, as Jaisaraji said, that you are doing a very good job. Pinjal and Meghna, both you are actually great. And actually, I had an idea just now that we can invite you or your team for anywhere you want to participate in our ICA events, Muscat Chapter events, to be to play a role in our events. So if you are interested, we can invite you for our roles for the upcoming events and future events as well. So this and Jaisaraji has actually done my most of the work. Inspector Chief Guest, Dr. Nasir bin Salim bin Nasir Al Gansubi, Jaisaraji, Dr. Sivakumar Manikandanam, Chairman Indian School Board, host of the event, Mrs. Sanchita Varmaji, Principal Indian School Sohar, distinguished speakers, students, it's given me an immense pleasure to address you on behalf of ICA Muscat Chapter. We wish all the students who have secured top positions in Commerce Grade 12 and are eligible for scholarship for awards. We also wish to congratulate all students who have chosen CA as their career after their 10 plus 2 exams in commerce. As Pinjal said, that doing CA is too difficult. So right now the situation is little different. Now the papers are, there are 50% objective questions and 50% technical questions. So maybe the passing percentage has significantly improved. Previously it was like 2 to 3%. Now we can see the results are coming up for 10 to 15%. So it's not that difficult. If you commit and determine, it requires determination and hard work. Success does not come by chance. It requires definitely your hard work. And if you do your hard work and you determine, so then you will definitely get success. And as Aishwaraji already said, so I don't have much things to say on the CA. As far as ICA Muscat chapter is concerned, we will definitely allow our programs to be shared with our students of Commerce Wing. And if any of the students is interested to join our programs as attendee or as a participants or want to give some sort of presentation to us, you are most welcome. You can contact Gauravji for that. And definitely we will help you out. And we will love to host you in our events as well. And you achieved a milestone, which we wish you all the success in the future. Under the COVID new normals, world has come within the reach of our fingers, and various options are available for the 12th pass students in the commerce, including CA. ICA has its global presence. Now we are in 45 countries, as already Jayasaraji has mentioned. ICA Muscat chapter, ICA members' contribution is being recognized in worldwide. ICA is also hosting World Congress of Accountants in November 2022, which will be all over the world's accountants will be coming in one banner. For benefit of students, ICA has created a huge resource in the form of e-libraries, Digital Learning Hub, ICA TV, and many more resources. ICA Muscat chapter is also coming up with, is publishing all our events on YouTube. If any of the students want to take benefit of these programs, they can go to YouTube and search ICA Muscat chapter, and you will be having a huge resource of knowledge. ICA Muscat chapter is also coming up with e-library, which will be announced shortly for the benefit of the students and the members of the ICA. We wish to thank ICA and Indian School Board for considering us for the consecutive fourth time to felicitate the students. And we definitely love to interact the student more closely, maybe in person as well. Now the COVID situation will change. We always have a phone call away in case you need any assistance to choose SEA as a career. And we once again wish you all success to the student. Thank you. Thank you, Pinjal.
Thank you, sir. I'm sure all commerce students, especially aspiring chartered accountants, have learned a great deal from your knowledgeable words. We also thank you, sir, for your appreciation and kind offer. Some people dream of success while others wake up and work hard for it. This quote by Wayne Huizenga is especially relevant this evening. Today, we have four such assiduous students whose drive and determination earn them top ranks in their Class 12 board examination. Arjun Amit Athalye of Indian School Muscat secured an outstanding 99.4% and topped the commerce stream from all Indian schools in Oman. The second position was bagged by A. Rahul Govindarajan of Indian School Al Ghubra, who has secured 98.2%. Lisa Andrea of Indian School Muscat has secured the third position with 97.6%. The third position is also shared by Vidushi Jagnani of Indian School Al Wadi Al Kabir. She has secured 97.6%. Congratulations to all the toppers.
Congratulations. We hope that excelling becomes a consistent habit for you all. Each and everyone gathered here today is well aware of the back-breaking, tear-jerking, and some would say soul-crushing effort required to clear the CA exam with its lakhs of examinees and even more levels, or so it appears. It's no surprise then that the Muscat chapter of the ICI has graciously decided to give credit where credit is due, to felicitate the students of the Indian schools in Oman. We congratulate CA Phoebe Grace Alexander, CA Durva Mahalik, CA Albert Denny, CA Abhinaya Nallasivan, CA Siddharth Shah, CA Shweta Madan, and CA Joel Lester D'Souza, who achieved this insurmountable feat and became the heroes of every aspiring student in the nation.
Congratulations to all the successful chartered accountants. We are all incredibly excited to witness the heights of your potential. I would now like to invite the chartered accountants to share a few words of wisdom to enlighten and empower all aspiring chartered accountants viewing this event. Phoebe Grace Alexander from Indian School Muscat has pursued CA articleship in Chennai and has passed all her CA exams in her very first attempt. Phoebe, I would like to invite you to share your experience.
A very good evening to one and all. At the very outset, I would like to thank God Almighty for his blessings, without which I would not be able to achieve this. I would also like to thank the Muscat chapter of ICI, the board of directors of the Indian schools in Oman, and Indian School Soha for hosting this event. I would like to express my sincere gratitude to the Indian School Muscat family, especially our dear principal, Dr. Raji Chauhan, and all my dear teachers who laid a strong educational foundation in my life. This journey was not an easy one, but I'm glad I pursued it. Don't limit yourself. Many people limit themselves to what they think they can do. You can achieve whatever your mind lets you. What you believe, remember, you can achieve. CA is a course which demands a lot of hard work and sacrifice. And there were many people who were not very encouraging during my preparation. But by God's grace and with hard work, I was able to achieve it. And I'm sure each one of you can. One thing that I didn't know before I joined CA is that CA actually demands a lot of mental strength rather than just the intellectual part of it. Because there will be many days where you feel like you can't make it. But don't be discouraged. Work hard and stay focused. And I'm sure you will be here a few years down the line, inspiring the next generation of CA aspirants. Now, coming to the preparation strategy. CA is actually not a very difficult course, but the syllabus is very vast. So try to make your own notes, as these will come in very handy during your exams. Secondly, time management is crucial. The CA course mandates 3 years of articleship right after your intermediate exams. So managing your classes and work can be a bit hard, but with effective time management, you can achieve it. I would like to conclude by saying, you have the unlimited potential to be, do, and have anything you want in life. You simply have to decide what you want and be willing to work long enough, hard enough, and smart enough to make it happen. Thank you all.
Thank you very much for sharing your enriching experience, Phoebe. CA Durva Mahale from Indian School Al Ghubra has cleared her CA final in July 2021. She has also cleared all levels of the CA exams on her first attempt. Durva, I invite you to share your experience with the audience.
Hello, Thank you, Meghna. Thank you for the introduction. And I would like to thank everyone who has conducted this event for inspiring our commerce toppers and commerce and students in the commerce stream to take up this esteemed profession like chartered accountancy. So thank you very much for holding this event. And congratulations to all the toppers. And I'm sure it must be a great feeling. Please enjoy it. I recently qualified as a chartered accountant in the July 21 attempt. I have always been very interested in finance, and I thought that definitely chartered, that there couldn't be a better profession, better professional course than chartered accountancy that would help me gain a deeper knowledge of all the fields of auditing, taxation. So it gave me a holistic understanding of all fields. So to talk about briefly about my journey, after completing my 12th standard, I pursued the CA-CPT, which is now the foundation, which is now called the foundation course, and then cleared the CA intermediate and pursued my articleship with from Deloitte, Haskins and Sells. And I would like to tell that anyone who is thinking about pursuing chartered accountancy in the future should definitely go for it. But you should know that if do it only if you're willing to put in those efforts and work hard towards your goals, because chartered accountancy is such a course that it requires tremendous hard work and it requires commitment to your goals. One more important thing is that you need to be very, very focused towards your goals, because it is a 4-year course which has as my other participant mentioned, that it has a vast curriculum. So to cover it and along with your articleship can be a little stressful, and has its own pressures that you have to deal with. So if you can handle it, if you are committed to your goals and willing to work hard, then I think you should definitely go for it. And as mentioned, that I think CA has, along with finance, definitely has taught me the importance of time management, because before pursuing chartered accountancy, I did not think that you can actually work for 12 to 13 hours productively. So to keep that momentum and to keep practicing and working hard is a difficult thing, but it's definitely not impossible. So I would definitely tell my juniors and the toppers, commerce stream, who have cleared that, definitely give it a thought. And it is a great profession. And I can tell personally that it has opened a lot of opportunities for me when I talk about the job market. So sky's the limit. And if any of you have any doubts or any queries, you can feel free to reach out to me. I'll be more than happy to help you all. Congratulations once again, and wishing you all the best for all your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Durva. C.A. Albert Denny from Indian School Muscat became a chartered accountant after clearing the CA final exam in November 2020. He is currently associated with Catalyst Muscat, a mentorship platform, as a student mentor. I request you, Albert Denny, to enlighten the gathering with your experience.
A very warm good evening to distinguished guests and invitees present at this event. I'm really honored and humbled to be part of this auspicious event, and I'm really thankful for this wonderful gesture. If you want something you never had, you have to do something you have never done. For me, the CA qualification was one such thing. It was my dream since 11th standard to become a chartered accountant. I'm blessed to have such an amazing family, teachers, and friends who have supported me at every point of this journey. One small piece of advice I would like to give to everyone who's aspiring to be a chartered accountant is that you must believe in yourself. You have to believe in your strengths, and you have to keep correcting your weaknesses. Half of your CA journey is done when you just believe in yourself and you have the right mindset to sit for the exams. Hence, it is rightly said, CA is not a tough course. It is a course for tough people. My heartfelt gratitude to the Board of Directors for Indian Schools in Oman and the ICI Muscat chapter for organizing such an amazing felicitation ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you, Albert Denny, for that wonderful sharing. CA Abhinaya Nala Sivan from Indian School Muscat has cleared all levels of the CA exam on her first attempt and cleared the CA final in November 2020. She is currently working with Aditya Birla Fashion and Retail Limited in Bangalore in the Finance and Commercial Department. Abhinaya, I request you to share your experience with the audience.
Thank you, Meghna. Good evening to one and all present here. Firstly, I would like to congratulate all the award winners, all the toppers, and everyone who's cleared their school, passed out from school, and entering into the new phase of life. So this is just the first step in life, and I'm just many more to come. So talking about my experience in CA, my CA journey, it has been a one-of-a-kind experience. And when I cleared my 12th standard, and I was thinking of going for any professional course, be it CA, ACCA, I was in a confusion what to do. So I heard a lot about CA, and I heard it is a very challenging course. So I thought, okay, why not? I'll give it a try. And I took up this course. I pursued my classes in Chennai, and I did my articleship from Deloitte Haskins and Sells, Chennai. So I would say this CA has one peculiar thing which is not available in a lot of courses, and which is something which is highly appreciated, is this articleship training, because this period, it gives you the practical ability to apply the concepts that you learn theoretically. So these practical application and the theoretical concepts, they complement each other. So this way you can retain the concepts longer. You don't have to necessarily by heart the thing. You can retain them longer, and you can apply them in any sort of situation. So like everyone has mentioned, definitely CA gives you the passport to any place in this world. You can work anywhere. You don't have to worry about job security. You can do that. But apart from all that, I think another important thing that the CA gives you is a respect in the society, because once you become a CA, your opinion is valued, not only with respect to the subject matter, but anything in general. It holds high respect in the society. I've seen that in workplace, even amongst your other social groups, they give a lot of value to your opinion. So you must definitely live up to that. You have to keep updating yourself. Even once you qualify as a CA, you have to keep updating yourself with all the amendments and everything. So this is a wonderful course. And definitely it has got its own challenges, because you will not be specializing in just one or two subjects. You have three core subjects: accounts, finance, and taxation. And so you will be specializing in all these three areas, and you have a vast scope. Once you clear, you can join anything. You will not be limited, confined to any particular course. So it is definitely challenging, but once you find a right approach and you apply that systematically over the next four years, you can definitely clear the CA. It is not impossible. And also, I don't think that we are scaring you. You can also have your own share of fun during these years, because articleship is nothing lesser than a regular college. You can definitely enjoy this period. And also, since you will be getting the conceptual clarity by practical application, this is a wonderful period, a wonderful opportunity. So all those who are aspiring to be a CA, sure, go for it. And I will be available on LinkedIn. So if anyone has any doubt, you can reach out to me and I'll be happy to help. So once again, congratulations to all of you and all the best for your future. Thank you.
Thank you, Abhinaya. Next, I'd like to invite CA Siddharth Shah from Indian School Muscat. He is a strong finance professional with a degree from ICAI. He is currently working as an assistant manager, head office operations in Mumbai. CA Siddharth, I request you to share your experience with the audience.
So good evening, honorable chief guest, respected principal, the guests of honors, teachers and students. At the outset, first and foremost, I would like to thank the ICI Muscat chapter, the board of directors of Indian schools in Oman, and Indian School Sohar for being such wonderful hosts, for organizing such a wonderful program. I'm truly humbled and honored, you know, to be a part of this program. Thank you so much for inviting me. This really means a lot. so as to say that it has been an incredible journey for the past 4 years since I pursued and I enrolled for the CA course. It has been a roller coaster ride with its ups and downs, but you know, truly enjoyable at every moment. I wanted to pursue this degree, this course, not for myself, not for you know, just not only for myself to pursue as a career, but especially for my dad, you know, as a dedication for him, whose dream was to have those two coveted alphabet CA, you know, prefixed to his name. So this one is for you, Dad. It's always has been for you. This acted as my sole motivator, you know, which has guided me through across the journey of my CA journey. And God has been kind that I could clear my CA finals in the first attempt in May 19. So it all adds up to that. You know, all this wouldn't have been possible, you know, without the support of a lot of people. So first and foremost is my family, who have given me such an unflinching support, you know, given me such an unflinching emotional support when I needed it the most, and their sacrifices have paid off a lot. So I'll be indebted for life to them. My teachers and my professors, especially my teachers at ISM and the commerce team, who have helped me in building such a strong foundation, which has really, really helped in excelling in my exams. And my friends, my colleagues, my boss, my principal, for you know, guiding me through and giving me such wonderful insights towards the experiences, which has helped me in, you know, tackling the exams. So to all the young aspirants and students, you know, who are keen in joining the course, and I would like to share with you a mantra which consists of four things, which should be your approach in life, but especially for the CA course. Is one is hard work. There is absolutely no substitute for hard work. You need to work hard so to achieve your goals. The next is your dedication. You need to be really dedicated towards and you know, focused towards your goal. Your focus and commitment and confidence. If you have these four in you, trust me, success is sure to follow. So I would like to just give a piece of advice to all my, you know, the CA aspirants. CA, though they say it's tough, it has its own, you know, challenges, but trust me, every bit of it is enjoyable. And when you overcome those, the level of excitement is, you know, it's indescribable. You can only experience it yourself. So, you know, they say when the going gets tough, the tough gets going. So that's what I have experienced that at each and every phase of my CA journey. And trust me, I think, hope you will also enjoy and learn from those experiences. So I would like to conclude by congratulating all the toppers, the winners of the quiz, and all my fellow CAs. Best wishes to one and all. Keep it going. Keep up the good job. And thank you so much once again. Thank you so much.
Thank you, CA Siddharth. Now, let's hear it from CA Shweta Madan from Indian School Darsay. She has experience in statutory audit, GST audit, and various audits at this young age. Over to you, Shweta.
Good evening, everyone. It is my pleasure to share this evening with all of you. And to all the toppers, my heartiest congratulations. So I started my CA journey in 2017. I went on to finish my CPT, which is the foundation now, intermediate and finals in my first attempt. So to put my CA journey in perspective, I would like to use the words of my lecturer. He compared the CPT to that of a pond, which is simple and easy to sail, and intermediate to that of a river, which is tougher compared to CPT, but you will anyway sail through it. And finals to that of an ocean. You just never know when this is going to end. So the course as such is challenging, but it is a known fact that with better risk comes better rewards. So if you are willing to give at least 5 years of your prime time, then CA is the course. With the opportunities that comes along with the prefix, it won't be disappointing. Thank you.
Thank you, Shweta. That was really enriching. We now have CA Joel Lester D'Souza, who is a chartered accountant and CFA level 3 candidate. Currently, he has set up a firm in Bangalore as a practicing chartered accountant. I now request CA Joel Lester D'Souza of Indian School Muscat to share his experience.
Firstly, good evening, everyone. Firstly, I would like to thank the Board of Directors, Indian Schools in Oman and ICI, Muscat Chapter for organizing this wonderful event to recognize the efforts of the students of Indian Schools in Oman and Chartered Accountants. I owe my professional success today to the strong educational foundation provided to me by Indian School Muscat. It's their culture to strive to be the best that gave me the perseverance to become a Chartered Accountant. I would also like to specially thank my accounts teacher, Mr. Alexander E. Varghese, whose passion for accounting is what made me love the subject and choose this career path in the first place. I would also like to thank my parents who played a great role in my success. They were always present to motivate me and help me throughout this journey. Becoming a CA is a journey that everyone does not complete. It's the people around me who believed in me, and it's this belief that kept me going forward and breaking the boundaries of what I thought was possible to achieve. I would like to share the good parts of my CA journey. As everyone's talked about the exams, I would like to talk about what I liked about the CA journey. So being a 19-year-old, I had started my articleship in Grant Thornton, and I really couldn't believe the responsibility that was given to me from day one. The CA course has given me access to talk to CFOs of big companies and liaison with them and get work done. After completing this CA course, the respect that I get whenever I talk to a client right now through my firm is tremendous. Whenever I mention that I'm a CA, they automatically start calling me sir and all. And right after finishing this course, I feel really ready. The knowledge that it's given to me, I cannot see in any other professional course. Like, let's say for ACCA, they have finished the exams, but they do not have that much practical experience. But me, I feel like I'm a thoroughbred professional because of this course, and I really owe a lot to this course. It has helped me break my boundaries. It's helped me be determined. It's helped me put consistent efforts of 13 hours every single day, and that's what's making my firm successful today. I would really like to finally thank my parents for always trusting in me. And thank you, everyone, and have a good evening.
Thank you, Joel. Hearing a first-hand account of the process from all of you today has done a great deal in assuring aspirants that this undertaking isn't as taxing as they think it is. This is a gentle reminder for parents and students to post your queries in the chat box, which will be answered by our professionals today. Now, we move on to a prize I take great personal pleasure in announcing, the ICAI Commerce Quiz Awards. To gauge the skills, abilities, and knowledge of students, to identify their talent, and to encourage them towards a commerce education, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, the second largest accounting body in the world, conducts a quiz for commerce students. This year, with over 32,000 students participating across 21 nations, I am extremely proud to say that two awards have been won by the students in the Sultanate of Oman. And fortunately, both these ICAI Commerce Quiz 2021 awards have been bagged by the students of Indian School Sohar. Ojas Golian, Class 12, Level 3, Rank 1. And Paki Golian, Class 11, Level 2, Rank 1. They are being awarded not only with a certificate, also with a massive cash prize. Congratulations. Say what you will about chartered accountants, but they look after their own.
Congratulations to the winners of the Commerce Quiz. Your hard work and perseverance has indeed been acknowledged and rewarded. I'm sure we can all expect greater achievements from you in the future. They say that your greatness is not what you have, but what you give. Perhaps this is why CA Vandana D. Nagpal is so great. She is a graduate in economics from Delhi University and is a member of CPA Australia. Presently, she is heading the Board of Studies and has actively participated in the review of education and training schemes of the Chartered Accountancy course. She is also responsible for the imparting of education to around 8 lakh students pursuing the Chartered Accountancy course. Ma'am, I request you to kindly address the gathering.
Thank you, Meghna. I must congratulate Meghna and Pranjal for the way they are hosting this event. Really, I'm really impressed. And I must say that I like congratulate and all of you over here for the manner in which you have been conducting this particular the studies of commerce are being taken up over here and how the students are being encouraged to rather take up the course of CA. And I must congratulate all the toppers of commerce, and I also must congratulate the students who have passed the CA course. And I also would like to congratulate the would-be CA aspirants who have won the CA this particular quiz award also. And I hope that many more amongst you will be joining this course and will bring a lot of laurels for your family, for ICI, and for your this particular school. I just would like to just mention that all of you, I think the ones who have passed the CAs, they have rather talked about the CA course that it's not tough, rather it is for tough persons. And I agree to that yes, it is for tough persons. And I will say that all those who are really tough, not physically I'll say, but mentally those who are very strong, they are the ones who should take up this course. And I must tell that it is not tough, because there's nothing like impossible, because everything is possible. If we really have a will to do it, we'll surely do it. So I just would like to briefly tell you as to what are we doing for our CA aspirants and for our CA students, so that it helps you to take up this particular course and excel in that. I must say that under the leadership of our chairman, CA Jay Chera, and our vice chairman, we have been doing a lot for the students. We are trying to do the handholding for the students. To start with, I must tell you that we have started with the live coaching classes. And these live coaching classes, we are doing it for all the levels. The ones students who are wanting to join foundation, we are doing these classes for them. Then we are also doing it for intermediate, and we are also doing it for final level students. And all these classes are being run online in the morning and in the evening, so they do not clash with your practical training and whatever else, the studies which you are doing. And I must tell you that all these classes, these are being run free of cost. The students do not have to pay anything for these particular classes. And we are trying to cover the entire course, and these are very interactive in nature, and students can join these classes from anywhere. So students, the CA aspirants who are there in Muscat, they can also join. From here, we are running these classes. We are starting at 7 o'clock in the morning. So I think for you, it will be starting at 8:30, right? It's from 7 to 9:30 for intermediate and 7 to 10 for the final level. And foundations are being done at from 11 to 1 and 2 to 4 in the afternoon. And in the evening, we are starting at 6 o'clock. So you can very well plan, and you can try attending these classes, which will really, and whatever queries you are having, the queries are also being taken up live by our faculty. So you will have no problems, right? And another very good feature is that if you are not able to see these classes online, you can see the video on demand also. All these videos are very much there on the ICA YouTube. whenever there is a playlist of the videos, and you can run those particular videos and you can see those videos and you can have your queries removed, right? And another new feature which we have brought in now is the mobile app. I hope a lot many of you would be knowing that we have come up with a mobile app for our students. It's named ICI BOS app. It is available on iOS as well as on Android. So once you download this particular app, you will be able to have all the features, what all we are doing it for the students, you can have it at one platform. It's a single sign-on platform for the students where they can see the lectures, recorded lectures, they can have the MCQ-based assessments, subjective assessments, you can get the material also over here, you can have your mock test also over here, you can have suggested over here, you can have the entire material including the ebooks also. Like the chairman had said that we have also having now the ebooks for the students. The very good feature of the ebooks is that students can see the classes, see the lectures online. You can make your notes over there. You can have the Wikipedia is also enclosed wherever you are not able to know the meaning. You can have the meaning also done over there. You can prepare the notes and you can save these notes also for future reference. So I must add another thing is that for all the theory subjects, we have also come up with the audio lectures also. So students, if you are traveling, you cannot read. So you can listen to the lectures, which will really help you understanding and utilizing your time. And I must also tell you that in the mobile app, we are also sending the push notifications for the students. Any important announcements, we are sending it through push notifications so that you are updated with what all we are doing it for you. And I must also tell you that we are now conducting the mock test series for the December exams. So, and the second mock test series is going to be in the month of November. And we are very shortly coming up with the suggested answers also, so that students who are appearing for the next attempt, it will help them in knowing as to how really to answer. Or if suppose they have not been able to clear the exams, they'll be able to know where they have gone wrong. So, and another thing in the mobile app, we have also started Ask Your Query. So any technical issues you are having in any of the papers, you're not able to understand any conceptual problem you are having, you can just send your query to us and it will be taken care of within 72 hours. So you don't have to go anywhere. All your queries will be taken care of by us. And another thing I also would like to tell you that from last year onwards, October 2020, the registration for CA course is now. You can do it after the students who have passed class 10th exams. You can register for the foundation and you can appear in the foundation exam after appearing in the class 12th exams. So this is going to help you in saving your 6 months time. And students who will be appearing in the foundation June 22 exams, they can register till 1st of January 22. Which will help them in appearing in the month of June 22. And we are going to start the classes for foundation students from in the month of December itself, so that students can prepare well in advance and can comfortably appear in the month of June 22. And also for students who are going to appear in the intermediate and the final May 22 exams, we are starting the online classes from 25th of October 21. So all those who are here, and you can just pass it across to your peers also, all those who are appearing in the exams, they can very well register through mobile app and they can very well continue to see the classes. And another thing which I would like to say is that we are also coming up with the revisionary test papers also for the students so that they are updated. And we are also coming up with the amendments also. All the updated material for May 22 exams is also now available, and very soon it is going to be available on the centralized distribution system also. I think you all would be aware that now there is no hassle of going to the chapter and getting the books. Updated books, you can place an order on the centralized distribution system and the books will come at your particular place. So you don't have any hassles. You have everything with the click of a button. And I must also advise you to kindly go through the student's journal also. It's very informative because it will give you, we are every month, we are coming up with the capsules for each paper at all the levels. So that this particular capsule, which is of 10 pages or 15 pages, is going to really help you in preparing before the exam. So it is going to just, it's going to give you the bird eye view so that you can just revise your course and you can comfortably go and appear for the exams. So make best use of what all is being made available to you by the BOS-ICI, and we are always there with you for any problem you are facing. And I must tell you, that CA is a wonderful course. And once you join this course, I'm telling you, it's not that you are restricted to the field of auditing, finance, or taxation. You are having, a lot many areas. Our chartered accountants now, they are business solution providers. They are not mere helping you in auditing, giving you advice in the, they're planning for you for tax. It's not like that. They are the ones, now they are the CEOs of the companies, and they are also the, they can provide you the solution. They are able to rather tell you how really to plan your business. Because once the business is in downtrend, they'll guide you as to how they can make use of the resources, keeping in view what is happening in the economy across. And they will help you to set up the businesses, which line of action they need to add, they need to go in. This is what is being provided by chartered accountants. So it's, once you join this course, sky is the limit for you. And I thank you all for giving me the opportunity, and any questions you have, I'm there for you. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Your words of wisdom will resound through the minds of students for years to come, and your practical advice has greatly helped our audience. And thank you for your kind compliment, ma'am. Ex-IAF Air Commodore Dr. Shminder Singh Bahal is a gallantry medal recipient Indian Air Force officer with 38 years of extensive experience in operations, academics, and research. Currently, he is working as Consultant Dean, Center of Excellence at ICAI. Known as an effective and able leader, he has a significant number of contributions to his name in the literary, academic administration, and research fields. He has published 4 books. I now request the ex-IAF Air Commodore, Dr. Shminder Singh Bahal, to illuminate the eager minds of the audience.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you very much. I didn't know you were speaking about me, but the moment you mentioned Air Commodore, it felt that, yes, I am the only Air Commodore here. So nice of you to say such beautiful words. DG Batina, South Governorate, Chairman, Board of Studies, Oman Schools, Principal School, and then CA Jay Chairaji. In fact, I consider him more as a friend because he's such a multifaceted personality. He's so beautifully acclaimed. He's got 30 plus degrees. I mean, he's also a movie star. He sings, he's a dramatist, and he's also into sports. I've never seen a personality such as CA Jay Chairaji. CA Vandana Ji, she's a dynamic director, Board of Studies, and I've seen her at close hand. The amount of improvements that have taken place in the Board of Studies as well as in the academics and the curriculum for CAs is phenomenal. Then CA Ravi Deora, a personal friend of mine, and a great and a dynamic leader, a visionary, and the way he's transformed the Muscat chapter, it's only seen to be believed. CA Gaurav Ji, and the two masters of ceremonies, who spoke so well, dear friends, and also the CAs who have, young CAs who have given such beautiful lectures. Indeed, it's a great, you know, I feel I'm greatly honored that I'm addressing not just the Oman toppers, but I have also part of that group which has spoken such beautiful words of wisdom just now. You know, what better I could add? I'm stumped. You know, it's something like this. You come on the 20th over and you have 20 runs to score and you have had great batsmen like Virat Kohli who have just gone back and there are high expectations on you and then you have to be like Dhoni. So you have to do the job. So now most of the things that have been covered are covered more on the chartered accountancy field, which I am greatly proud of. That's such a beautiful profession. But let me tell you about life also. Let me tell you about how to succeed in life, how to succeed in a career. A very good evening and namaskar to each one of you. And I'm humbled by the previous speakers. I also take this opportunity to acknowledge the lovely program and the amount of good work that the Indian schools are doing there in different parts of Middle East. You know, a word about our great country, India. We are the sixth largest economy in the world in terms of nominal terms. That is $3.05 trillion. And we are the third largest economy in the world in terms of purchasing power parity. That is $10 plus trillion, $10.21 trillion to be exact. Who makes the country's economy so strong? And one of the pillars is Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, ICAI. It is the economic warriors such as yourself who are in the being, who are going to make sure that our country becomes great and becomes one of the great powers in the comity of nations. And the rightful place we get will be because of people like you. No, there are many great things about our country. The first thing I can think of, it's the largest producer of fruits, milk products, cotton. Can you believe it? 62 million tons of cotton we produce. We are the second largest consumers of two-wheelers. We have the third largest army in the world, the fourth largest air force in the world. Incidentally, yesterday was Air Force Day. So any kid who's related to an Air Force family, a very happy Air Force Day to you. And the seventh largest navy in the world. We are also the IT and BPO hub. We illuminate the world with our brain power and our intellect. And you know what is best after that? Above all, our country is a young country. While the world is growing older, India is growing younger. 51% of our population is 25 years or below, and 67% is below 35 years of age. And you happen to be part of that youth revolution. And we have great expectations from each one of you. You know, at this stage where you are, it is very, very natural to be confused. Mujhe kya karna hai? Main kahan jaunga? What will I do? What is the career I should choose? Which is the field I should take? Where do I see myself in the next 5 years? And I'm telling you, chartered accountancy is a beautiful field. After having been associated with it for the last few years and associated with such personalities, I have learned that the true warriors are the economic warriors, and ICAI plays a great role and chartered accountants play a great role in that. So what do you want to do when you are confused? The first thing that you need to do is to do self-evaluation. Undertake that self-evaluation. What are your strengths? What are your limitations? What are your likes? What are your dislikes? What are your abilities? What is your aptitude? What is your talent? And what do you really want to do in the end? Because if you have the aptitude and talent, and if you want to do it, then choose that profession. Because you'll always be happy. You saw those young CS, such big smiles telling you, it is tough, no? But when the going gets tough, the tough get going. Ask a military guy when you're getting fired apart from all sides. And then you say, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. And that is what is you guys. You know, there are five key capabilities that today are required in a chartered accountant, because it's an industry 4.0 environment, an environment that is filled with VUCA, volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. In this environment, you need five important capabilities, and that is descriptive. That is the first one. Not only should you be able to describe data, but you should be able to understand each and every factor at play. So you must know the entire world in general and your own region in particular and your own business in particular. And second, and important, is inquisitive. You get into it, get into data, identify the causes which are bringing out this situation. Third is predictive. Now predict where the company is headed. What is it likely to achieve? What is its balance sheet going to be in future? Cash flows, what is it going to be? Is it going to go up, down? Are they going to be tight? And then be a doctor. Prescriptive. Prescribe the medicine so that you can do course correction. And lastly, and most importantly, preemptive. That is, even before you reach a critical situation, you are able to preempt and now charter a course for your company. And that is why today a chartered accountant in technological environment is no more just a bookkeeper. Today, he's a business strategy analyst as well as a recommender of business strategy, so that not only does he tailor the business strategy to make his own company and the nation great, but he also understands how the entire financial system functions. But I want to ask you, is your life going to be easy? Absolutely no. And nobody's life is easy. Was my life easy? I'm not sure. I've always considered it very good. That's why I keep smiling at this age. Nobody's life is easy. And no, life is not going to be easy. I'm reminded of a person called Winston Churchill. I'm sure you guys know it. He was the Britain's prime minister during World War II, when 62.5 million people died. There's large-scale death and destruction. War was at India's shoulders also in the East and Northeast. But also, he was heading at that time the allies, which included America and many other countries. And when Hitler got defeated and the war was over and London was half destroyed, he went for a convocation ceremony. The children asked him there, "Sir, what was the single most important factor that made you win World War?" I mean, imagine the amount of death and destruction. You must have wanted to give up any time. So what was the single most important factor? As was his nature, he lumbered to the podium. And when he reached there, he said five words. Just five words. And then he went and sat back. Initially, there was a stunned silence. And then there was thunderous clapping when people understood the meaning. He just said, "Never, never, never give up." You know, when the night gets darkest, dawn is just a breath away. And this is my own quote. I'm not copied from anywhere. And let me tell you this, you know, I have seen this in my life. Hum girenge, par uthenge. Hum phir girenge. फिर उठेंगे हम गिरेंगे उठते रहेंगे जब तक कि हम सीखेंगे नहीं और जब तक कि हम जीतेंगे नहीं. Every fall will make us learn. We'll become more humbler. We'll become more knowledgeable. And we'll be able to take on the world's challenges. So when, if ever, you fall in your journey of becoming a chartered accountant, remember these words. Never, never, never give up. And you will see, you will succeed. There's another thing in this, you know, which I have said, which was obliquely said, is emotional resilience. People who succeed in life, do you see great leaders as IIT or IIM or something? No! Great leaders are those who have great emotional quotient, great emotional resilience. Means what? Means they are not only able to manage their emotions when everybody around them is losing their head, they are also able to take the right decisions and not open their mouth in anger. There'll be a lot of times in life that you will get angry. Angry with your family, angry with your siblings, angry with your colleagues, angry with your boss. But remember, muh band rakha to sab jeet liya. This is the second learning I'm giving you. And this is the most important learning if you want to succeed in life. Always maintain your emotions. And remember, human beings are like elephants. They remember. They remember for very long. And once you tell your boss that you are an nincompoop, though it is the fashion of the day, your career is over, not just in that company, but anywhere you go. So please, please be careful when you are really worried, when you're really depressed, when you're really nervous, and when you're asking God, why me, maine aisa kya kiya hai? That time, maintain your emotional toughness, your emotional stability, and also those of people who are around you. Do not lose your head. Now, when we talk of mental toughness and when we talk of everything else, do not forget physical toughness. You know, till 5 years back, I could beat 75%, I'll say, of the university students in Amity or any of these universities in running. I mean, I was that time 55 years old, and those guys were just anywhere from 19 to 25, three times younger than me. But why? Why? Run, remain physically fit, earn a lot of money. I have nothing against earning money. Earn a lot of money. But don't earn to give it to the doctors. Earn for yourself. Earn for your family. Earn for having fun. And when you have fun, do physical exercise. Maintain your physical fitness. Remember, 12 hours of study when you're doing, I also do the same amount of thing, 10 to 12 hours of work, and then you still go for a walk or a run. Run if you can. Walk if you can. If you can't walk, crawl. But crawl every day so that at least 4 to 5 days in a week, you are remaining physically fit. You do exercise for 30 minutes. Please do that. And then you'll have the strength to climb to mountains. Perseverance I've touched. Emotional resilience I've touched. Physical fitness I've touched. But life is like a train journey. You know? There are many stations when you want to go to your destination. But you do not know which will be your last station. When you will leave this world and God will say, beta, beti, aajao mere paas. You don't know. Nobody knows. I mean, you have to be God to know. At that time, remember, you should have done something. Kar kuch aisa ki dunya banna jaye tere jaisa. And that's exactly what you have to do in life. Be good. Be helpful. You don't know how good will ever come back to you. Itna dukh hai dunya mein. Itni takleefe hai. Agar logon ki help karoge, to Bhagwan aapki help karega. That person may not be able to help you, and help those people who cannot help themselves because God wants you to help them. That's why he gives you that situation. Help them. Please help them. Last thing I want to touch upon before I want to end. I know you guys will be great. I know you guys will be technologically sound. I know that you will achieve mountains. Respect your elders. Respect your bosses. Love your juniors. Dilon ko jeetne ki kala a gayi, samajh lo kamyab ho tum. I will say it again. Dilon ko jeetne ki kala a gayi, samajh lo kamyab ho tum. Otherwise, you are a failure. To really succeed in life, win people's hearts. Kar khudi ko buland itna ki har takdeer se pehle, khuda bande se puche, bol teri raza kya hai. Make yourself so great that even God has to come down to this earth before writing your destiny further to ask you, what do you want, friend? I'm very thankful to the Muscat chapter, especially to my friend Ravi Deoraji. I again congratulate each and every topper, winner, but I also congratulate each and every student who may be listening here. Remember, being a good human being is better. And then being a good human being and a good professional is better. And then joining Chartered Accountancy is good. Have a nice day. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, sir. And you are I'm the student of yours as well, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your awe-inspiring words. We have had an incredibly enlightening time this evening, and I'm sure that we have all learned something new. To further enhance this learning opportunity, now is the time for all the queries of parents and students to be answered by our professionals present with us today. Over to the professionals. The first question is from Jyoth, who wants to know which app you had mentioned, CA Vandana ma'am, in your speech today.
It's ICI BOS mobile app.
We'll share the link as well with the teams.
Yeah, what I'll do is I'll be sharing this particular link with you, which you can share with the students, right? Students, if you are having the Android phone, you can go to the Google Store, Play Store, and you can download this ICI BOS app. And if you are having the Apple phone, you can go to the Apple Store, and again, you can download this particular app, right?
Thank you, ma'am.
The second question is, does one need to have an aptitude for maths to become a CA?
Annaji.
We don't want, we are not expecting you to be the very good in math, but you need to have an aptitude. You can, your mind works in such a manner that you can do calculations, because you don't require as such, there is nothing manual. You have to make use of the softwares. You are having the calculators. So there is no such issue that if you are very great in math, if you are very great in maths, then only you can do it. Not so. You need to have aptitude for this particular CA course, right?
More towards the commerce type of thing, not trigonometries and triangles and other things. So if you are more commerce towards...
Because we are not into all these. See, you need to know calculus, but we are not wanting you to be expert in calculus. Integration. We are not wanting you to know that, but basics of mathematics you should know, and plus you should have aptitude. You have that skill that you want to really interpret things. A good logical person. If you are logically strong, I think you can be a very good chartered accountant.
The next question, does one need to pursue a BCom degree to become a CA?
Yes, if you are having a BCom degree, you can join the CA course through direct entry scheme. And even if you are not if you are not from the commerce background, you have not done BCom, many of the chartered accountants have come from the science background or from humanities also. So it is not must. It's just that you want to be a chartered accountant. I said you need to be logically very strong and you have a will to become a chartered accountant. I think there is no such restriction that you need to do a BCom. Only then you are able to do chartered accountant. Right? I quote my example. I had done till 12th, I had science. I had maths, physics, chemistry and bio, and I was wanting to become a doctor. Somehow I felt that, yes, I will not be able to bear the smell of the OT, operation theater. So I opted out of medical. Then I thought, no, I'll do now. I joined economics honors because I wanted to pursue my career in economics. I got admission in Delhi School of Economics for MA, but I opted out of that, but I joined chartered accountancy. So I had taken a 365 degree turn, and here I am in you in front of you. I wanted to be a CA, so I have become a CA, right?
Thank you, ma'am. Our next question is, what's the difference between ACCA, ICAEW and CA, and which one is better?
See, I am not here to tell you the difference. What I can say is the ICI, the CA course of ICI is the best. It is the toughest. It's not that because I'm heading the BOS ICI, it is not that. The curriculum which we have is the best. What others are not having, we are having. We are making you a wholesome professional, which others are not. Yes, they have their own USPs. We are not for that. We are not here competing with anybody. But I can say the course of ICI is going to make you the business solution provider. Our chartered accountants from ICI are there all across the world, and they're heading the organizations. You can see also in Muscat also, like how many chartered accountants are leading the various organizations. You know that. So what we are giving, what we are teaching to our students, plus combined with our practical training, 3 years of practical training, which is making them a wholesome kind of a professional, which can do, the professional who can solve any problem, right? So that's what I'm saying. CA from ICI is the best.
Ma'am, here I want to add one more thing, that a few of the leaders recently we had interviewed, and we spoke with them, and those people have said that we are hiring ACEC and ICWA team members as well. But when we compare to the CA course as well, so those people may require additional training.
Yeah.
To be aligned to those things. When we acquire CA, it's already trained and already stone is actually crushed.
Yeah. You are very right. Yeah. You are very right.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. What are the different levels or courses in completing one CA education?
There are 3 levels. If you're coming, if you're joining CA course after 12th standard, we are having foundation level, then intermediate level, and then final level. If you're coming after doing graduation, then we are having 2 levels, the intermediate and the final.
Thank you, ma'am. This Q&A session was truly illuminating, and I'm sure we'll see hefty returns on this investment of time and energy very soon in the form of passionate and hardworking CA aspirants. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Honored. You're greatly honored.
Gratitude makes sense of our past, brings peace for today, and creates a vision for tomorrow. No event would be complete without a solemn and heartfelt expression of gratitude, the gift that keeps on giving. Keeping this in mind, I invite CA Gaurav Kapoor, the Chairperson of Students Affairs and Professional Development for the Muscat chapter of the ICAI, to deliver the vote of thanks.
What a fantastic evening it has been. And no regrets for missing my Saturday evening badminton with my friends. Thank you all for giving the opportunity to participate in this vibrant event, where we celebrated the success of all of you who came out in flying colors in recent concluded various examinations and contests. I am indeed reminded of my student days, preparing for exams, the dreaded exam days, waiting for the result announcement day, and those few moments where we all held our breaths when the actual results were out, and the feeling of relief thereafter. It is an honor to have been asked to offer a vote of thanks on this occasion, where we felicitate all the achievers and toppers for the hard work and determination that gave them the result that they achieved. I'll just touch upon few of the words that have been said in the last 90 minutes or so, which not only define you in 3 to 5 years of your CA course, but makes you a lifelong professional. Of course, technical skills combined with communication skills, the managing skills, mental strength, time management, focus, hard work, determination, and dedication. Believing in yourself and having that confidence, descriptive, predictive, prescriptive, preemptive. Continue to have the right mindset, emotional resilience, and importance of silence. Very, very important. Start winning hearts. You can learn technical skills, but winning hearts is the most difficult part to learn. Of course, someone said, this is not a tough course. It is for the tough people. And it lays down the strong foundation for whatever you do in life. Maintain health, very important. You can get money, but you cannot earn health. You have to maintain it. Life is not easy when there, but that's why when you pass through tough times, sky is the limit. And finally, I can vouch for myself as well. You will get high respect and value for your advice by being a chartered accountant. On behalf of all those who are gathered here, I express my gratitude to all the dignitaries and speakers for sharing their graceful words. And special thanks to our chief guest of the day, Dr. Nasir bin Salim bin Nasir Al-Ghanbusi, Chairman of the Board of Directors of Indian Schools, Dr. Siva Kumar, Principal of the Indian School Suhar, Mrs. Sanchita Verma, and other principals of Indian schools present on this occasion. Guest of honor, CA J. Charya and CA Ravi Deora. We also thank CA Vandana Nagpal and our precious Ashminder Singh Bahl for his special motivational address. Thanks to Meghna and Pranjal for making it as professional and smooth. And thanks to everyone present on this evening. Last but not the least, I would also like to pass on my special thanks on behalf of the whole of Muscat chapter of ICI to Indian School Gubra, Principal of the Indian School Gubra, Mrs. Papri Ghosh. Special thanks to Mr. Suresh Kumar and all the support staff for conclusion of the CA exams in the past year, especially during complete lockdown time. A milestone we never thought of achieving, and with equal support from our Vice Chairman, CA Sajeev Sundaram, and also equally supported by the Indian Embassy in Oman. Once again, congratulations to all the achievers, and may you scale greater heights as you progress. Last, saying the five golden words of this evening, never, never, never give up. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. As for my understanding of this field, there are two key rules for building a successful accounting business. Number one, don't tell them everything you know. Number two, product it. And my humble advice to my fellow students is, be all that you can be. Shine your soul with humility as a rainbow in the sky. And no matter where you go, you'll find yourself. I,
Meghna Jaikumar, bid adieu to all the luminaries in attendance and each and everyone greets this program with their presence. Thank you.
And have a pleasant evening.
Thank you, Indian School Sohar, for doing such a wonderful job.